Don't call my line again, okay?
Barrister, this is important.
Don't call my line again! Don't call my line again!
Dear subscribers, meet Sir George Clement from Lagos. Yep, this idiot scammer actually believed that he could pass himself off as a British peer of the realm, someone who had been knighted by Her Majesty the Queen. Sir George operates what is called the recovery scam. This is a particularly devious scam where he mass emails the world, advising that if you have been scammed, Sir George and his online group will recover your stolen funds for a small fee. Of course, he isn't a recovery agent, and if you pay him his fee, all you will receive is a request for another fee, then another, then another. Sir George gets fat while you get broke. That's how this English knight works. I decided to have some fun at his expense.
Hello.
Sir, it's Mr. Pricky.
Yeah, okay. I can hear you.
I have some good news for you.
Okay.
I am at the counter now. I have given the money to the clerk.
Okay.
The clerk is here with me now and is going to speak with you to give you the payment information. I am going out for a cigarette, so I will be back in a moment. Mr. Fahal, can you take the call? This is Sir George Clement.
Okay. Hello?
Well, hello, Mr. Falker. Yeah. How are you?
I am fine, thank you. Is this Mr. Sir George?
Yeah, this is Mr. Sir George.
Okay. Listen to me, my friend. I have a payment for you from Mr. Pricky.
Yeah?
For the amount of £300. Is that right?
Okay.
Can I ask you a few questions, Mr. George?
Yeah, what's that?
Why does Mr. Pricky sending this money to you? In what kind of business?
It's to help him recover from certain things that he really needs. So can I have you to see a number now?
So there is no money laundering and there is nothing illegal about this deal.
So can I have you to see a number now?
No, I need to ask you. There is nothing related to money laundering and everything is legal in this deal.
No. Everything is okay.
Okay, I have the MTC number with me now, but I need to speak with you first, Mr. George, okay?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Yeah, Mr. George, I know that you are a dirty motherfucker scammer from Lagos, from Nigeria, okay? I've been working in the Western Union for a long time, and I've seen all these victims sending money to West Africa. So this is your business, and this is my business. I don't care about your business, okay? So what we're going to do now, I'm going to send you £50 out of the 300. I'm going to keep 250 for me. Okay? And you're going to tell Mr. Pricky that you have received the full amount. You have a deal.
Why is it like that? Because he sends me 300. You have to let me have it so that he can get what he's looking
for. No, I'm not going to send the full amount. I need the money, my friend. I work as a part-time pimp. I need to recruit some bitches. I need this money. So I'm going to send you 50. Listen, don't argue with me. You have two choices. Either accept £50 or nothing.
Okay.
So do you have a deal?
Okay. Can't you do it 150, 150?
No, I cannot. I need the 250. Since you're arguing with me, it's not going to be 50. It's going to now £30. So then don't continue arguing with me. Accept it or leave it. I have many customers here.
Hello, Mr. What's your name again?
Fahad. My name is Fahad.
Mr. Fahad, why do you do this? Why? Can I know why you're doing this, please?
This is business for me. And it's like a business for you. You are a dirty motherfucker scammer. I am a dirty Western Union clerk.
Listen to me. I'm not a scammer, okay? He knows about it.
I don't care. Shut up. £30 now. Don't continue arguing. It's going to be down to 10. So accept the £30 now, better than nothing.
Okay, make it 100. Make it 100.
No.
Make it 100 so that you keep 200.
Now it's 25. Now it's £25. Don't continue arguing with me.
Please, can you give him the phone so I can talk to him?
Okay, I'm going to tell them that you are a scammer, okay?
Okay, listen to me, sir. Oh. Listen to me. You don't do things like that, okay?
No, I do it like that. I see many victims all the time, and always I do this deal with scammers like yourself, and they always accept. Because, you know, something is better than nothing.
That's true, Mr. Fahad, but I want
don't
you
continue.
To know. I want
it's 25
you.
Now. Don't continue. I accept.
Can I talk to you? Hello?
Yes, you can talk to me, yes.
Okay, listen to me. You see, I'm a man of honor. I'm a Christian, and I don't engage.
You are a man of dirt. You are a dirty scammer. You are a man of nothing. So accept 25 or nothing. Don't waste my time. I can give you the MTC number now.
You never say 25. Please, I'm begging you. He needs this money too. He needs it. He needs it.
Okay. Now it's 20 pounds. Don't continue. You will be down to nothing. 20 pounds or nothing.
Why are you doing this?
Because
give him the phone.
Idiot.
I need to speak with him. I need to speak with him. This must stop. You are working there, and why will you do this? He asked you to give me the MTCN. Just imagine what you're doing.
Listen, stupid fool. I'm not gonna give you anything, and you need to accept my offer. 20 pounds. Now I can give you the MTC number.
Give him the phone.
Fuck you, idiot. Okay, just one second. Call him, Mr. Prickly. He's outside smoking. Call him back.
Jesus.
Yeah, Mr. Prickly. This is the guy. He's a dirty scammer, okay? Don't send him any money. Yeah, come on.
He's going to be calling Mr. Prickly back.
Yeah, he sure is. I bet he's calling right now.
Make it 100, idiot.
Whilst we're all laughing, Sir George calls me on my mobile. So the call quality isn't too good, but you can hear much of what he says. Subtitles are available if you want these.
Sir, say again. What do you say? He offered you what? £50?
Yes, he said he would give me £50 and he would keep £250 for himself.
I don't understand.
Look, Mr. Freaky, he's a bad man. He's a wicked person. He's a scam.
Sir, listen, there's a MoneyGram office down the street. Can I go to the MoneyGram office instead?
Yes, go MoneyGram. Go to MoneyGram, call me back. Go to MoneyGram now and call me back, please.
Yes, sir, I will do. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
40 GB pence minute, that just cost him a few naira.
Folks, there is a missing call here. Sir George's mobile reception was so poor that much of it was indecipherable. Simply put, Pricky went to the MoneyGram office and gave the £300 to Bob Pencer, the clerk, and went outside for a cigarette. Bob told Sir George that he wanted £200 for himself. Sir George refused, so Bob told him to persuade Pricky to send £500, not £300. Bob would then take £200, and Sir George would still get the full £300 he wanted. Sir George agreed and sent Pricky off to the ATM to withdraw a further £200. So we're now back in the MoneyGram office. Bob Pencer has the £500 in cash, and Pricky is outside again smoking. What Sir George doesn't yet realise is that Mr. Fahad owns all of the MoneyGram and Western Union outlets in the region, and this one is run by his stepson.
Hello.
Oh, Mr. Clement.
Hello.
Hey, this is Bob Pencer. Yes, this is the MoneyGram agent. I don't know how you did it, sir. You're amazing. We come back with £500.
Okay.
Yeah, you're amazing. How did you do that?
You told me that you want you up to 200 so you can send it 200.
How were you able to do that?
It's a thing that I told you before that is a Lego thing. So it wasn't hard at all. So can I have it now?
Okay, here we go. I'm going to send you £15. And I'm going to keep £485. and I thank you so much.
What's the meaning of this? What's the meaning of this? What's the meaning of this?
What?
Why are you people doing this? Why? Why?
Sir, I'm trying to do business.
Just listen to me. We're going to need the money again, okay? Give the money back for Mr. Pretty, and that's it. That's fine.
Hang on. Dad, come here and talk to this guy. He doesn't understand
business. Okay. Hello.
Give the phone back to Mr. Pretty.
Fuck you, man. I'm not giving the phone to anyone. Listen to me, okay? He did a mistake. We're going to send...
Give the phone back to Mr. Pretty. Give it back to Mr. Pretty.
The final choice for you, £70. This is the final thing I can do.
Listen, I'm a man of God. I don't want to insult you, but God, RSR, we told you. My God is going to... You're not going to say this Christmas. That's me. You're not going to say this Christmas. You're going to die young. Trust me. You're going to die young. In the morning. Give back to Mr. Pretty.
I'm going to put Mr. Pricky's name on the black list for all MoneyGram and Western Union in the UK. He will not be able to send a single penny to you anymore. So you need to accept it. £70 is better than nothing, my friend. Okay?
You are a thief.
You are a thief. Idiot, fool, motherfucker, shit sucker. Listen to me. £70 is nice.
Fine, no problem. You can say anything you want to say. But
Dad,
can
we get the horse tonight?
Yes. Call them now. Call Jen. Jen, she's nice. She has a big booty.
Yes, I'm calling them now. Thank you, Dad.
£70, my friend.
Give it phone back to Mr. Pretty. I don't need your fucking offer, okay? But remember, you are going to die young. You will die young. I told you that.
I am old. I am old, you idiot. I am 65, so I'm not young, you idiot.
Okay, don't worry. You will see. You will see what's going to happen to you, okay?
Final offer. Final offer, okay? £100. This is the final thing. I will keep 400. Don't be greedy. I know you are a thief. You are a criminal. You are a scammer.
Okay, no problem. If you say that, no problem. But remember,
oh my God,
you are going to pay back.
John, I feel something in my chest. I feel some pain.
Daddy, Jen says she's going to be able to make it. She's coming.
Excellent. God bless you. Mr. George, listen, £100 or nothing.
Give it back to Mr. Pricky. I need to talk to him.
Okay. Call Mr. Pricky from outside. He's smoking. Tell him here. Tell him he's going to blacklist him. He will not be able to send any money from MoneyGram or Western Union in the whole UK.
Hello?
Mr. Pricky?
Hello? Mr. Pricky. Hello, sir.
Hello, Mr. Pricky.
Yes, sir.
Hello, Mr. Pricky. What is the meaning of this? What is happening here? What is happening? Why are you playing with me? I don't understand. What is happening?
Sir, I have been outside smoking a cigarette.
Listen to me, Mr. Pricky. Listen to me now. They said the money you sent, the £500 you sent, they said they want to hold it. They want to use it for their upkeep, that they are not going to send any money down here.
But I don't, sir, I gave them £500 to send to you. You told me to get £500. I obeyed your command.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Mr. Pretty, they refuse to give me the information. They say they want to keep the money for themselves, that they need the money too. They refuse to give me the information. Mr. Pretty, collect that money now, collect info, and send it to me yourself. Text it to me, SMS it to me now.
No, I don't send SMS, sir. SMS is insecure.
Okay, call it for me. Can you do that for me now? Do it yourself.
They haven't given me the reference number. They still have the money.
Okay. Mr. Pretty, can you travel to another place and do this tomorrow? These people, they are wicked people. They don't want to give me money out.
Well, sir, about 5 minutes walk away, there is a late night store and they have a Western Union outlet. Shall I go there?
Okay. I hope I won't speak with anybody again. That will not tell me to give him money.
Sir, I don't want these problems to occur. It is late here. I had no idea this would happen.
Okay, how much are you going to pay down for this place?
500. How much does the clerk keep for commission?
Okay, they said they before they told me it was 400.
Yes.
Okay, now they are saying they will give me 15. Why do we keep 480?
I don't understand, sir. I'm new to this. But listen, I will go to the other Western Union outlet and I shall call you back in about 10 minutes.
Okay, please. I don't want to speak with anybody again apart from you, please.
Okay, my friend. Leave it with me. Thank you.
Folks, the fun with Sir George continues in part two. I won't spoil the plot, but I will tell you that there is a lot of mileage in this idiot. I hope to see you there. Oh, and by the way, we would be very happy if you gave us a thumbs up for this upload. And if you haven't already done so, please click on the subscribe button and you will be the first to know every time we upload some more audio gold. In addition, if you check out our Twitter and Facebook pages, you'll see our photos of real scammers that we have sent across the world on wild goose chases, only at ScamBait Central.